Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to work with formulas in the React spreadsheet component. I will also show you how to set formulas through the data source, how to set formulas in the formula tab in the spreadsheet ribbon, how to add user-defined functions, and how to work with named ranges in formulas. First, I open my existing project, where all the necessary spreadsheet modules are configured, and the basic spreadsheet rendering code is written. Notice that the data.js file has local JSON data. Let's look at the formula data. It has the fields date, open, close, high, low, and profit. Notice that the field profit contains a formula to find the difference between the close and open fields. This is one way to set a formula or expression in spreadsheet cells through the data source. Using the sheets directive tag, I have mapped the data source to a specific range in the sheet. In addition to that, I have added the columns directive tag and specified a custom width for individual columns using the column directive tag. You can refer to my React spreadsheet getting started video to learn more about local JSON data binding. I've included a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run this example with this formula data and show you the output. You can see that the spreadsheet rendered with the formula data. When I edit any cell in the profit column, you can see the formula. You can also insert a formula by clicking this button under the Formulas tab in the spreadsheet ribbon. I choose the roundup formula and provide the cell address. I can drag down the autofill handle to round all the other cells in the profit column. Here, I want to limit the decimal value in the profit column to explain a few more formulas. Let's see how to apply a number format to this column on initial load. I add the created event, which will be triggered after the component is created, and assign the callback method on created. I define this function here. To access the spreadsheet's built-in method, I declare the variable spreadsheet object and create an instance using the ref property. In the onCreated method, I call the method numberFormat using the spreadsheet instance. Then I pass the decimal type and cell address as arguments. Checking now, we can see the numberFormat is applied to the profit column values. I can directly edit any cell and save a formula. Let me show you how to do it. I'm going to find out the average profit. Double-click cell F12, type the formula equal to average of F2 to F11, and press Enter. I can show the maximum stock value by using the max formula for the high column. You can also fill the cell address by selection. And I can find the minimum stock value using the min formula for the low column. Check the user guide link provided in the description to find the list of formulas supported in the spreadsheet component. You can also edit the formula using the formula bar located at the top of column header. By default, this formula bar is enabled in the spreadsheet. You can disable it by setting false to the show formula bar property. I would like to keep the formula bar, so I set it to true. Next, I will show you how to sum a profit column using the formula property in cell data binding. I add a rows directive tag to specify a collection of row details. Using the row directive tag, I specify details for a single row and set the index to 11. Then I include the cells directive tag to specify a collection of cell details. Using the cell directive tag, I specify data for individual cells and set the index to 5. I add the formula property and set the value equal to sum of F2 to F11. I add another cell to display the formula caption. I set the cell index to 4 and set the value property to total profit. Checking it now, the formula is added to the cell F12 and the caption is added to the cell E12. Next, I'll show you how to set a formula by using the updateCell method inside the created event in the spreadsheet. In the onCreated method, I call the updateCell method using a spreadsheet instance and need to pass the cell model. Here I add the value property, assign the value average, and provide the cell address as E13. Then I again call the updateCell method, pass the formula as equal to average of F2 to F11 as the cell model, and specify the address F13. Checking the spreadsheet now, the formula is set to the cell F13. The formulas supported in the React spreadsheet are sufficient for most of your calculations. If you need a function that is not included, you can add your own custom function using the addCustomFunction method. Let's see how it works. I define a constant method, calculatePercentage, which requires two cell addresses as arguments to calculate. Then I define the percentage calculation here. In the onCreated method, I call addCustomFunction using the spreadsheet instance and pass the name of this method. Then I specify the formula name. Then using updateCell, I set the header for the column G as percentage by passing the value property. I will also set the percentage formula with the required cell addresses. I specify the resultant cell address as G2. Checking now, the percentage column is added, and the percentage is shown in cell G2. When I drag this cell, percentages for other cells will be calculated. Finally, I'll show you how to work with named ranges. You can define meaningful names for cell ranges and use them in formula calculations. Include the define names directive tag to specify the collection of named ranges. I then add define name directive to provide details for a single range. I add the name property and assign the name profit. I add the refers to property and assign the address F2 to F11. Checking the spreadsheet now, when I use the name profit in the sum formula, the result will be displayed for the range defined. Spreadsheet formulas support cross-sheet references. When I insert a new sheet, the sum formula will display the result for this named range profit. Another way to work with named ranges is by using the addDefineName method inside the created event. I comment out the defineNames directive tag and call the addDefineName method using the spreadsheet instance. Here I provide the name and range address. Checking the spreadsheet now, when I use the name profit in the average formula, the result will be displayed. In this video, I have shown you how to work with formulas in the Syncfusion React spreadsheet component. I also showed you how to set formulas through the data source and the formula tab in the spreadsheet ribbon, how to add user-defined functions, and how to work with named ranges in formulas. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our React products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.